इसको बदलना। सो प्री ऑपरेटिव प्रिपरेशन इज मस्ट बिकॉज यू हैव टू वर्क ओवर द सैक्रल प्रोमोटरी। सो 24 आवर बबल प्रिपरेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड। क्लियर लिक्विड्स एंड पेगलेट और एक्जेलाइट शुड बी गिवन प्रायर टू द सर्जरी। सो द बबल रिमेन अवे फ्रॉम द फील्ड। जनरल एनेस्थीसिया कैन बी कंबाइंड विद एपिड्यूरल बिकॉज एपिड्यूरल हैज टेंडेंसी टू ब्लॉक द स्पलेंचिनिक नर्व सप्लाई टू द बबल। सो बबल विल रिमेन कॉन्ट्रैक्टेड। Ask the anesthetist not to use too much of nitrous oxide because nitrous oxide has a tendency to diffuse in the intestinal lumen, so the intestinal will come in your field. Suture material, as you want, it is a non-absorbable suture, 2-0 or 1-0. It has excellent clotting property and has less memory. You can use chlorine, but it is little difficult to tackle chlorine, and as you want, it is very simple to handle like Bactrim. This is the final position of the mass. This is the bladder. After dissecting the bladder down, anterior vaginal wall is exposed. Similarly, you have to push the rectum down. So the posterior vaginal wall is also there. So you have to take a T-shaped mass, fix one arm over the anterior vaginal wall, one arm to the posterior vaginal wall, and tail to the sacral promontory. This is the lateral picture. This is the one arm, two arm, and this is the third arm. You can call it as a T-shaped mass or bi-shaped mass. So in the literature, there is a lot of number of procedures are available for managing this problem, but I personally think laparoscopic sacrocolpopexy is the best approach for managing this problem. So before going for the video, I would like to show you the anatomy of the ureter. So this is the sacral promontory. Here, this is the bifurcation of the aorta. And this is the sacral promontory, so uterus will be somewhere here. This is the right ovary. So this is the common iliac vessels. So ureter crosses from lateral to medial side after crossing the common iliac vessels at the level of sacral promontory. Then this ureter runs with the internal iliac vessels till the uterosacral ligament. Can you appreciate this ureter? It is crossing the right common iliac vessels on the right side and just crossing lateral to medial at the level of sacral promontory, because you have to dissect over here. So you should know the anatomy of the ureter also. Then it will run with the internal iliac artery and then it will end over the uterosacral ligament. So this is the ureter, you can appreciate. This is the CCL extractor. One system will keep this end in the vaginal wall, in the vagina, so the hornices will be well delineated. This is the proline mass available in each and every OD. You can cut it into T-shaped fashion or bi-shaped fashion. You cut a long strip and a short strip. Fix the short strip with the long strip in the center and fix it with the echo non-echo, which is either proline or adhemon. So now it is a T-shaped mass. So this is the patient post hysterectomy came with the problem of bowel prolapse. So here you can see the good bowel progression first. You have to dissect. Obviously, since this is a post-op case, so you will expect some adhesions. After clearing the adhesions, you have to dissect from the sacral promontory. You pick up the peritoneum, cut over the peritoneum, then the sacral promontory will be exposed. And you have to remember that you have to work over the right half of the sacral promontory. And you have to keep on dissecting this till the right uterosacral ligament, medial to the right ureter. These are the only two silent features which you are supposed to keep in your mind. Right half of the sacral promontory, medial to the right ureter. You have to cut the peritoneum. Now, CCL extractor is inside the vagina. This is the, so give a nick over the peritoneum and push the bladder down. Similarly, on the posterior aspect, you have to push the rectum down to expose the posterior vaginal wall so that you can fix the one arm of the mass over the. So you keep on dissecting till the levator arrives. So the rectum will fall down and you will able to stitch the mass over this. Always keep eye on the ureter. And after dissecting it, Do not use too much of 40 over the vaginal bolt, because here you have to fix the mess. So it is better not to use too much of pottery to hamper the mess quality. Minimum use of pottery should be done. And now, fix anterior leaf of the T-cell mass over the anterior vaginal wall after pushing the bladder down. Once the bladder is pushed down, the ureter will fall laterally. So, always be careful not to take any bite through the bladder. Otherwise, patient may have BVF. So, fix the mass over the anterior vaginal wall. 3-4 stitches are sufficient. Similarly, fix the mass over the posterior vaginal wall. So basically you are covering the vaginal wall with the help of two leaves of the mass. Taking suture in the post pouch of Douglas is a little tricky, but in few cases it may be tackled. Now, one arm of the mass you have to fix over the sacral promontory, over the right half of the sacral promontory. I have used tackers in the past, but my experience with tackers are not good. Patient usually complains pain. So I have started taking suture. Non-adherable suture, either proline or ethimol. You can take suture over the sacral promontory. But if the patient is very fat, there is a lot of fat between the peritoneum and the sacral promontory. So in those cases, you should be very careful while dissecting this area. And then you can fix the mass. Ask your assistant to guide the CCL extractor towards the right half of the sacral promontory, and this mass should not be very tight. Otherwise, later on what will happen, the further fibrosis will make it more tight and patient may have pain. So it should be loose enough. It should not be very tight. And take 3-4 sutures, and if you are not comfortable with suture, you can use tacker over here. Then this is the final picture of the mass. You can appreciate, and then you cover this mass with the peritoneum. Cut from the sacral promontory to the right uterosacral ligament with the help of bicurl. So you can see that this mass, so basically what we are doing, we are just doing retroperitonization of the mass, because I don't want to leave mass inside the abdominal cavity so that it can invite the bowel and can cause some acute intestinal obstruction. So it is better to nicely cover the mass with the help of peritoneum. Always keep eye on the right ureter. So this is the final picture of the mass, and you can appreciate this is the whole mass has been retroperitonized. So complications, of course, lower urinary tract injury, bowel injury, vascular injury, and mass erosion. So lower urinary tract injury, how to prevent? Polish catheter in the bladder, identify the right ureter. At dose before dissecting the sacral promontory, and careful placement of suture should be done, not to take suture through the bladder or ureter. Bowel injury, good bowel preparation is must. If the bowel is distended, it is keep on coming in the your field, assistant will keep on pushing it, it can cause injury to the bowel. Patient position, head low should be there. Left lateral tilt can be done so that the bowel will fall away from the right half of the sacral promontory, and NG tube can be used. Vascular injury, obviously you should know the anatomy of the lateral pelvic bowl, and identify vessel free area of the sacrum for mass fixation. So to conclude, I think laparoscopic sacral palpography is the best option for this problem. Okay, thank you very much.
Presentation. What I would like to add, instead of joining the mesh, you can take a longer mesh, go anteriorly, go posteriorly, and the rest of the portion that comes to the sacrum. So we don't have
but
to stitch the mesh in between.
I have not joined the mesh. I have taken a long strip of mesh, and I have taken a small strip of mesh, and I have fixed the small strip. But if I will do according to you now, posteriorly it will be doubled. Doubling of the mass will be done. Yeah. See this is the bolt.
This is the posterior, and this is got.
No. This is the bolt, okay?
Yeah.
You are asked, this, suppose this is bladder. Right. You are putting one arm over here,
yeah.
Second arm over here,
yeah.
And then you are coming back with the sacral promontory. So posteriorly it is doubled. So ideally it is not recommended.
Yeah.
Am I clear? So basically you should make it mess and tricep mess or bicep mess, whatever you want, and then you can go ahead. Okay, thank you Dr. Misra for giving me the opportunity. If there are any questions, I will be happy to answer.
Is it an antibiotic before the surgery or how you prevent that?
How do you?
Please use antibiotic before the surgery.
There is only metrogel and first or second generation kefalonil should be given. I am not asking about urinary tract infection. Please, this gas light should be off. Or you switch on the light, please. You have to fix the mass over the right half of the sacral promontory, because on the left half of the sacral promontory, mesenteric attachment is there, vessels are there, so try to avoid on the left half. Right half of the sacral promontory, medial to the right ureter, that's all.
From your experience regarding vascular injury, I think the most common vascular injury here, the veins flex in the sacrum, and it's very dangerous when you have bleeding there, and I see very high morbidity from
So I just want to add one thing. When I was trying to learn this procedure 10-15 years ago, what I did first few cases open. And there was a fear in my mind, as you are having this fear that there are plexus and probably aorta injury. But believe me, aorta bifurcates quite above the sacral promontory, and there are hardly any vessel over this area. Only problem is in the fat patients, where a lot of fat is there. In those fat patients, this fatty layer contains few vessels. So it is better you coagulate these vessels with the bipolar and cut. There is hardly any plexus, there are no plexus, forget about the vessels and plexus. Always keep on eye on the right ureter.
Why did you stitch over the sacral promontory? How deep this stitch should be?
It should go anterior ligament only. That's all. It will guide, the bone will guide you. Once you will strike over the bone, your needle will curve, rotate, and you will come out. You cannot take a stitch in the bone. So only anterior ligament, which is present there, or whatever tough structure is there, you take the suture through that. But tether, I have very bad experience.
Take the whole depth of anterior
ligament, because this is the basic anchor. No?
I don't know, we have been using the tethers since a long time and have not had any problems.
Sir, you are quite right. But what happens, I was initially, when I was in AIIMS, no? We have to use one tether for many cases. So that is the problem. Yeah. If you are a very rich person, your patient are very rich, cost of it, that is 18,000. So you if you want to use tether, rest tether should be used, because once the infection will settle in the periosteum, bone or mass, yours life will be hell.
Please, if you don't mind, I have two questions.
Sir.
The first one, the vagina, is a good reservoir of different microorganisms. Yeah. Is there any risk of infection
or for
complication of mesh application this side?
No.
There is no
risk. Okay. Only periodic preparation is required.
Betadine of what?
I will clean the vagina with the help of betadine. That's all.
That's
I will try not to take suture through the vagina, but if it goes through the vagina,
yeah,
but CCL extractor is there.
Yeah.
That will guide you and your needle will rotate. Even the suture will go through the vagina, nothing will happen. Infection is no problem. There is no problem at all from the, you are dealing with the rectal, I think rectopexy you are doing.
Yeah.
Sometimes suture goes through, is there any chance of infection? I think vagina is less contaminated than rectal.
Because of presence of mesh, I mean.
Second question, sir?
The second question is, can this surgery be done without using of mesh, only by doing application of multiple sutures, retinolially, for the free sacral? Can be done without, because traditionally in open surgery there is such option. Can we do this option in laparoscopy?
What option? I couldn't get your question.
Traditionally,
use the mesh, just fix the mesh to the sacrum.
Okay.
Without the mesh.
First of all, the apex of the vagina will not come to the sacral promontory. Second thing, the ligaments of the vagina already cheated the patient. Don't trust the person who has cheated the things. Because the ligaments are already weak. If you will further take few stitches, what will happen? The again, things will come out. So, and the advantage of using mesh is that first thing, it doesn't like you can operate this procedure by early. But in that you have to cut the vagina. But if you are using mesh, you need not to cut the vagina. First thing. Second thing, the direction of the vagina will remain same. Third thing, there is additional support to the vagina with the mesh. So these are the three advantages of using mesh. So I personally think these are the advantages why we should. But never try to fix the mesh with the vagina with the uterosacral ligaments. The ligaments are already deep.
That is true, Dr. Dutt. The mesh definitely gives a better advantage and the results are definitely better. Okay. Any other question? Otherwise, we finish the session.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Delegates.